This video is going to be more for information's sake, and so don't—I don't know what the right way to say this is—but don't get too stressed out about it. We have the ability, just so you know that this exists, is why I'm doing this. We have the ability to store, for example, let's say we wanted to store the student first name and the student last name. Well, we could create one array for first names and one array for last names. We could do that. But Java does give us the option to create what we call a two-dimensional array. All right. So what I've done here is I said I want a 10 by 2 array, and I'm going to try and draw this a little bit better. So what this means is in my students array, now that I've got it declared as a 10 by 2, so we have the original array, but we're going to create a second dimension to this array. And so now we get 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. And so this is element 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 going this way, but we have elements 0, a row 0 and 1 going this way, right? So if I wanted to store, for example, the last names of each of these individuals, I want to kind of do the same thing. Element 0, 0 is going to be this element right here that will store Michael. Michael. Okay. If we want to store a last name for that person, we could do 0 element 1, which would be the next row in that same slot, and we could say Bluth. So now Bluth goes into this element. Right there, Michael Bluth. Okay, so that's element 00 and 01. Well, what would the next slot be? 10, right? Would be where Lindsay is. If we're looking at it this way, now it's 10, and then one element 1 would be Bluth. I guess technically it would be Fuque, but I don't know how to spell that. Okay, so then we here would be element 20, and then 21 would be Bluth. And so on and so forth. And so what we'd get then, of course, in this case, they're all the same name, but this would be the Lindsay. I give up on writing, but you get the point. So now we've got two dimensions to this. We've got the across, and we've got the up and down. And you guessed it. Can you have more than two dimensions? Yeah, you can. You could have three dimensions. We could have a 10 by 2 by 5 array, and that would be a three-dimensional array, which would become really confusing. That's why we don't use these too often. They just get cluttered, they're just confusing, or at least in my experience, they do come in handy sometimes, but we don't use them a ton. And so we could go through and do that for the rest of the array. And so I don't bore you, I'm going to pause for a second and then put the rest of this into an array. And just like that, through the magic of video, I am the only one that gets annoyed by typing all that in. Okay, so you don't have to witness it. So now we've got the first and last name. So the first names are in the first row, element 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, and then the last names are in elements the second row of the array, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, because we're looking at that ones row for the last names. All right. So let's see. So now the trick is, what if I want to print all these? So I'm going to put this array back to the way it was. I'm going to start at 0. Go while I is less than students dot length, and then I plus plus. So this will print out only the first names of each of those individuals. Oh, and because I added a second element there, I need to tell it that it's going to be a two-dimensional array there. Okay, so then we print it out, and it will print out a bunch of junk. Let me see what I'm doing here. Oh, the problem is I'm only printing the first dimension. So we want to be on row zero only. So notice I only had one element on that two-dimensional array. So I'm added a second element here. And now it'll print out the first names. And by the way, that's an easy way to print out the last names. And now I can just do I element one, and that'll print out all the last names. Well, what if I want to print out the first name and then the last name? This is where it gets a little tricky. Actually, I could do this very simply by just having it print element 0 and then element 1. But if I wanted it to be flexible for multiple rows, then we get into this idea of a nested for loop, meaning we've got a loop inside a loop. So I want to do for each row, I want to print out. So let me get rid of this for a second. So I want to loop through for every element in the array, but for each element, I want to do two rows. So I need to have two inside this array that's going to go to 10, if that makes sense. So I add a second loop for an int j equals 0, because I want to start on row 0. Well, j is less than the number of rows, so I'll say less than 2, or I could say less than or equal to 1, and then increment j each time. So do you picture what's happening? It's going to go, well, we'll watch it work once we get it done, because I think that'll be easier. So system.out.println, and what I'm going to print is first. The first time through, I want to print the first name. And so I, well, we'll see what happens here. I want to print, but I don't want to do a print line because that'll take me down to the next line. And I want to print out students element what? Well, I want to print out element I, j. This is where you really start to hurt your brain, don't you? Okay, so let's just try that for now and see what happens. Okay, good. It did print out all the names, but it printed them out one after the other. Now notice what it did here. Now let's watch. The concept of multidimensional arrays, like I said, has some use and validity, but we don't see it too often, right? The concept of a nested loop is very important, so that's the part I want to emphasize here. So if I come into this loop, then I is 0 and j is 0. So the very first thing it's going to print out is element 0, 0, which holds Michael, right? Then it comes back up to the top of this inner loop, increments the j to 1, and then says, now I want to print out students element ij. Well, I hasn't changed. I is still 0, but j has changed to be 1. And so it'll print out element 0, 1, Bluth. Okay, we increment again, so j is going to be 2. It'll exit that loop and go back up to this loop and increment I by 1. So now I is 1 and j doesn't exist because we left that loop. Well, now we come back into that loop and j will be 0. So then it'll print out element 1, 0. And then increment and print out element 1, 1. and then 2, 0, and then 2, 1, and then 3, 0, and then 3, 1. Now, just watch how this works. It's always going to be 2 for that inner loop, and then it'll go up and increment the outer loop, and it'll keep doing that. So 7, 0, 7, 1, 8, 0, 8, 1, 9, 0, 9, 1, and then we should exit out of that loop, and we've printed out all of those names. The only problem, obviously, is that we've got them all on one line. So we want to print the names, and we want to have it, we really want to have some spaces in between. So I'll add a space here after the first name. But really, we need to, this is why it would probably have just been more simple to print out element 0 and then element 1. But if I wanted to do this, I could say if J equals a 0, then print out whatever that element is with a space, else, or I could say if J equals 1, that's probably better. If J equals a 1, then system.out.println students element I J. So if it's a 0, then I'll print out the name followed by a space. Otherwise, I'll do a print line, meaning after I get done printing, to go down to the next line, and then I'll print that element. And so if I run this now, it should print out the names like I expected. But again, this is kind of a hokey example, but the idea that I can get a list of all these names and go through and very easily print them all out. If I had 1,000 names, it would be a pain in the butt to input them, that's true, but to print them out, this statement wouldn't even change. In fact, we wouldn't need to change anything because we've used the length of the array here. The only thing we need to change is if we had more than 2 rows, we'd need to change this number. But we can save ourselves so much trouble by using arrays. And then the other part we're going to find out is we can read in from a file. So we could just have these names exported from somewhere. We could read them in from a file using a for loop, going through one at a time and populating the array, and then print it all out using an array, and we can end up saving tons of lines of code. So anyway, that's the idea of multidimensional arrays and also nested for loops. That's why we use them a lot of times, is to be able to kind of walk through a process. I want to do this thing, you know, 10 times, but for each of those 10 times, I want to do this other thing 5 times. And so we get into those nested loop situations. Again, kind of more for informational value, for fun. But hopefully that's helpful to kind of maybe understand arrays a little bit better. All right. Spencer out.